This is what happens when college students go crazy on 420. They get high or drunk, and they put a closet in the A2 Porter Lounge. Hey guys, since all y'all know, blockbuster season is coming up, and for the past few years, a comic book movie has always started up, particularly from Marvel, so I figured I'd make a list, I haven't done one of these in a while, of my top 10 favorite superhero movies. Probably the most pointless list ever made, but there will be a few surprises in there. One that's going to be very controversial, but let's get to it. These are my top 10 favorite superhero movies. Number 10 is the latest film in a series that I did not seem to care about because of one movie in particular, but this movie managed to bring me around to loving the series again, and that is X-Men First Class. Now, I know when it comes to the X-Men movies, a lot of people prefer X-Men 2, which admittedly is a really good X-Men movie too, but First Class is special because after X-Men Origins Wolverine, I was like, okay, I am done with X-Men movies. I am done with any movie Marvel-wise that is not made by Marvel Studios and is not part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This and The Amazing Spider-Man managed to turn that around. Although, out of those two, I prefer this over The Amazing Spider-Man. I mean, other than that, it's got really good music. The fact that Bryan Singer is back on board as a producer, I think, bumped up the movie. It's got a really good cast. James McAvoy, Michael Fassbender, Jennifer Lawrence, the list goes on. It's just really good, and a good redemption to the X-Men series. Number 9 is a movie that, whenever these lists are done by other people, it's usually at number 2. And it's basically the granddaddy of all superhero movies, Superman the Movie. Now, the reason why it's at number 9, why it's this low on the list, is because it's sort of outdated. In my eyes, it's outdated. This movie came out in 1978. And I've seen a lot of superhero movies before seeing Superman, and while this is really, really good, it's just a lot of other movies are just seemingly better. I mean, other than that, it's got Christopher Reeve as the pitch-perfect live-action Superman. It's got impressive effects for its time. I mean, like the Godzilla movies, you can hardly see the strings that are carrying Christopher Reeve when he's flying around as Superman. And it's got one of John Williams' most famous scores ever. And it's just, despite it being outdated in my eyes, it's seemingly really good. And it set the bar for what other Superman movies have to do. So, Man of Steel, I think, has a shot of being good, but it's gonna be tough to come close to this movie. Number 8 is a movie that I think kind of goes underappreciated. I mean, it's definitely not going to be on anyone else's favorite superhero movies list, but it's certainly on mine, and that's The Incredible Hulk from 2008. While the Hulk is a very, very difficult character to make a movie out of on his own, this one did a much better job than the Ang Lee one. Bruce Banner is more interesting in this movie than he is in the Ang Lee one. It's got some really cool action, especially the last 20 minutes when Hulk and Abomination are just beating each other down in Manhattan. I don't know, there's just something about this movie that I think goes underappreciated. I can definitely see why people aren't a fan of it, but I think it's really good, although it's going to be tricky to make another standalone Hulk movie because how do you go beyond him running from General Ross and just rinse and repeat? So it's going to be tricky, but I'd like to see what happens next. But for now, I think The Incredible Hulk will do fine as a solo Hulk movie. Even if we don't get another one, this is a pretty good Hulk movie. Superman may have been the first real superhero movie to come out, but this movie is possibly the reason why the superhero series kicked off, and that is Tim Burton's Batman. It's funny, the more time goes on, I hear from a lot of Batman fans like, oh, this movie sucks. Especially since Christopher Nolan's Dark Knight series has finished. But for someone who doesn't read DC as much as he reads Marvel, I thought this movie was pretty good. Yeah, fans got a little pissy about the Joker killing Batman's parents, but you know what? In terms of the movie, that's pretty good because it made for a good hero-villain relationship at the end, especially since Batman is the one responsible for making the Joker who he is. And that, it's got really good things. While Christian Bale makes a good Bruce Wayne instead of Batman, I think Michael Keaton makes a better Batman than he does a Bruce Wayne. It's got little subtle hints of humor. Jack Nicholson is really good as the Joker. And it's got the definite Batman theme by Danny Elfman. I mean, as much as Hans Zimmer did a good job in the Dark Knight movies, this is the definitive Batman theme. I honestly don't know why Batman fans seem to hate this one, but I mean, at least it's not Batman and Robin, so, but enough of that. This just is a really good Batman movie, so that's my number 7 pick, Batman. Number 6 was probably one of the most difficult known heroes to portray on screen that actually worked, and he's got a movie coming out this November, Thor. Having the idea of Kenneth Branagh taking on this pseudo-Shakespearean superhero was a really smart idea. Chris Hemsworth makes a really good Thor. Loki, played by Tom Hiddleston, is one of the most fun villains I've seen in a long time. Expanded the Marvel Cinematic Universe even more by bringing in the whole god element and Asgard. Got some really neat action, though it does peak at the beginning and kind of decrease in the end, which is not bad. I don't know, this was a movie that I was really nervous about because a lot of people were talking shit about it before it even came out. And the fact that it ended up being good really made me feel good in the end. So, Thor, just a really, really fun time and my 6th favorite superhero movie. Okay, here it comes. DC fans, sharpen your pitchforks, light your torches, grab stake, nails, cross. Whatever you have to do to crucify me, here we go. At number 5 is the movie that should technically be number 1, but isn't. The Dark Knight. Now that you're done booing, let me explain why. While this movie is phenomenal, really fantastic, it is going to stand the test of time as the definitive superhero movie. It's the movie that made people take superhero movies more seriously than just something for kids. It's very dark, very complex, and has many, many moments of Hitchcock-type intensity due to Heath Ledger as the Joker. It's fantastic, but the reason it's not at number one for me is a couple reasons. One, it's just obviously I'm more of a Marvel fan, and I've tried not to let that affect my pick for this, but I just can't help it. The other 4 movies that I pick over this are just seemingly better, but that doesn't mean this is bad at all. I mean, it's on the list for Christ's sakes, and I just listed everything good and phenomenal about this movie. I even reviewed it. You can go see the review for yourself. Also, I thought the ending was a bit bullshit. I mean, just, I didn't like it at all, but it didn't ruin the movie at all. It's still a really good movie, gonna stand the test of time. It's just the top 4 movies that I pick, I personally enjoyed more than The Dark Knight. But The Dark Knight is probably the most famous and will stand the test of time as the superhero movie at number 5 for me. Number 4 is the only movie on this list that's not DC or Marvel related, and the only reason it's even here is because I see it as a superhero movie, and because there was not enough room in my animated films list. It's The Incredibles. I mean, back in the day, I was not that fan of a superhero movie. I did watch the Spider-Man movies and enjoyed them, but wasn't crazy about them. The Incredibles was the one I really, really loved. I mean, because it's Pixar. Aside from Cars 2, Pixar can never do wrong. Really good characters, really, really funny. The first superhero family. Obviously, there's been like permanent teams like the X-Men and Fantastic Four, but they were like a bunch of people. This was like a definitive family, a father, son, mother, daughter, and baby. It's really action-packed, great music, This is Brad Bird's masterpiece. Even with Iron Giant, this is, I think, Brad Bird's masterpiece. It's definitely the one he's most known for. Really, really fun. The way it tackles a bunch of other superhero bits is just really clever. As Pixar's best, no, this is not obviously Pixar's best, but it's... I think after Wall-E, Bug's Life, and the Toy Story trilogy, this is my favorite Pixar movie. So, I mean, that's all I have to say, is The Incredibles, for lack of a better word, is incredible at number 4. Number 3 is a movie that would scratch a lot of your heads as to why it's this high, but I've got my reasons for it, and I'm not ashamed of them. Captain America, the first Avenger. I know a lot of people, like, kind of groan at the fact, like, ugh, Captain America's lame, but... I mean, this movie, I thought that too, but this movie really showed me how cool of a character he was. And the reason I prefer this over The Dark Knight is because I relate more to Steve Rogers than I do to Bruce Wayne. I mean, look at me, I'm a weak, well, okay, maybe not anymore, but I used to be a weakling like Steve Rogers was before he was injected with Super Soldier Serum. I always got picked on. Mainly, like, I really related to the character Steve Rogers, and the fact that he rises up to the challenge is very inspiring. And, it's really fun, also. It's got a lot of good action. I love the setting. I love the fact that it takes place in the 40s, during World War II. Got some really neat art direction. The way they show how he becomes Captain America is really cool, and I liked how they made the suit a military-type uniform. And Chris Evans really does sell you as Captain America / Steve Rogers. The rest of the cast is good, and it's just really, I don't know, really a fun movie. I really enjoyed this one a lot. And yeah, Captain America at number 3. Number 2 came out the same year as The Dark Knight, but was the ultimate reason why I gained an interest in superhero movies, and that is Iron Man. Okay, I will never do that again. Like so many things I promised I'll never do again. But anyway, Iron Man. Wow, what a movie. This... I mean, casting Robert Downey Jr., who at the time I was like, joke, whatever. Fantastic as Tony Stark. He was so good that you were jealous. You wanted to be that guy. The suit is, like, awesome. Got really good music, really cool action. Although, like Thor, it peaks at the beginning and kind of drops in the end, which, again, is not bad at all. Has a pretty surprising ending for at least when I thought superhero movies were just going their usual route, like, superheroes have to keep their identity a secret. But at the end of Iron Man, I just, like, he's, like, he tries to cover it up, and it's like, you know what, screw it, I'm Iron Man. Like, you don't see that in superhero movies. Really good writing. Let me tell you something. To show a really good superhero movie, at least in my eyes, like The Dark Knight, does your dad like it? Because my dad does not like superhero movies at all. And at the time, when we went to see Iron Man, he was like, I'm only seeing it because you guys want to see it. Afterwards, I came out like, wow, I was liking it a lot. I loved it. And my dad was like, you know what, that was actually pretty good. So, thanks Iron Man for making my dad love a superhero movie. Okay, maybe not love, but at least like. And, yeah, that's Iron Man. I want to be Iron Man so badly. Unfortunately, the suits like that can't exist, but... Hey, a fan can dream, can he? Now, we're at number 1, and there's some movie out there that I didn't mention that made a lot of lists after it came out. It was something big, something monumental, something... Oh, screw it, it's The Avengers. You've heard me talk about this in my top 10 favorite movies of 2012, where it made number 1, and it made number 1 on this list also. What do I say that I haven't said already? I mean, this movie turned me into a giant Joss Whedon fanboy. The fact that he brought Iron Man, Hulk, Thor, and Captain America all together in one movie one movie was just incredible, and the fact that each of them got enough screen time, even Black Widow and Hawkeye. When this movie came out, it was probably the most nerve-wracking because, like, man, this movie's been hyped up for 5 years. If this sucks, I'm gonna be heartbroken. Luckily, that was not the case at all, and it ended up being the third highest-grossing movie of all time, and one of the best superhero movies ever made. Just absolutely amazing. The reason I prefer this over The Dark Knight is because, aside from me being a Marvel fan, is because it happened at all. Like, The Dark Knight will stand the test of time as the definitive superhero movie. This is impressive just for the fact that it's never been done before, making a few individual movies with individual characters and then bringing them together in one movie and making it work is just incredible. I mean, I love the Avengers. I mean, it's just, there's not much more I can say about it, but the Avengers, it's awesome. If you really haven't seen it, what are you doing? Well, that's my list. My favorite superhero movies of all time. Thank you guys for watching. Iron Man 3 comes out in 2 weeks, and I will be reviewing each of the Marvel Cinematic Universe films so I can go in depth with them even more than I have here, and eventually leading up to the review of Iron Man 3. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you don't take putting The Dark Knight number 5 too seriously, but if you really disagree with me on that, please leave a comment down below. Just don't be a jerk about it. Just leave a comment down below, and I'd like to get into a conversation with you about it. So, yeah, I look forward to your feedback, and I will see you guys later. Bye.